Isaac, Jacob, Ishmael. I like to know, what did Jacob write and what did Ishmael write, sir? David, Solomon, Elijah, Elisha. Surah Al-Ma'idah, 30 to 31, echoes of all things, a fairy tale. I read to you just verse 30 and 31. But he states here, the mind imposed on both the killing of his brother, on him the killing of his brother. He's talking about Abel and Cain. Incidentally, the Quran doesn't know their names. They're never mentioned. Then it states that Allah sent a raven scratching the ground, and by observing the story, the scene, now this brother buried his brother whom he had killed. Do you know that Pirkei Rabbi Eliezer, a story was written 200 years after the birth of Jesus, tells us Adam and Eve, sitting by the corpse of Abel, wept, not knowing what to do, for they had as yet to know any knowledge of burial. A raven coming up took the dead body of its fellow mate, and having scratched up the earth, buried it thus before their eyes. That's the very exact words, with the difference it's Adam and Eve instead of Cain and his brother. If Islam could trace its origin and prophecy to Abraham, then we would expect to find the Old Testament referring to Allah, Muhammad, Mecca, the black stone of the Kaaba, and the many ceremonies and practices of Islam. But the Bible is devoid of references to Muhammad, and there are no biblical references whatsoever to anything Islamic. It is much more reasonable to conclude that Islam grew from the polytheistic and animistic culture of Muhammad's tribe. In fact, the people of Mecca worshipped 360 idols, one of whom was named Al-Ilah, Muhammad's father. What was his name? If he brought new revelation, how come his father's name was, as most of you know, Abdullah, the servant of Allah, God? From the second Targum, dating back to the second century AD, we find the source of Surah An-Naml, and it is very fictitious. I'm not going to read you the Quran, I'm going to read you what this is, and you think it's the Quran. Solomon gave orders, I will send kings and armies against thee, of jinni, beasts of the land, and birds of the air. Just then the red cock, a bird enjoying itself, could not be found. King Solomon said that they should seize it and bring it to by force, and indeed he sought to kill it. But just then the cock appeared in the presence of the king and said, a bird is speaking, I had seen the whole world, and know the city and kingdom of Sheba, which is not subject to thee, my lord king. They are ruled by a woman called the Queen of Sheba. The end of the story is fascinating. As the bird goes and carries a letter, and she comes back, and when she arrives, she sees the palace, and the floor is of glass. She thinks it's water. She tries to uncover her legs, and the king screams. This is in the Quran. Cover your legs. This is not water. This is not a sea. This is glass. What an exciting story to be written in the Quran. The New Testament is borrowed, so much of it, that in reality, there are so many sections of it that 130 passages in the Quran refer to the Bible as Law, Psalms, and the Gospels. Also the apocryphal fables. Surah Ali Imran, the family of Imran, verse 35 to 37, closely follows a spurious gospel account proto-evangelism. And it talks there about the famous story of Zechariah, his wife, and the birth of their girl. Christian heresies. It is fascinating to discover that Muhammad did not believe in the Trinity, the divinity, and the resurrection of Jesus. To understand why this was so, we must examine the deviant doctrines of Nestorians and the followers of this man. Sectarian Christians who migrated to Arabia 140 years before Muhammad's birth. Muhammad apparently drew these denials from their heresy. Nestorius was the Patriarch of Constantinople in AD 428. He did not believe the same truth as the Bible teaches, and therefore he was rejected. What did he do? He and his followers fled to different places, among them Persia and Arabia, where they made their acquaintance with the family of the Prophet. Most Christian scholars believe, and Muslim history attests, that Muhammad came in contact with Nestorians during his travels to Damascus when he was 12 years of age, and Buhayra saw in him the possibility of a prophet. 12 years later, he convinced him of that, traveled with him, and taught him most of what he knew about what we call the biblical stories from the Christian viewpoint. Heathenism. The ancient Arabs reportedly had 7 celebrated temples dedicated to the 7 planets. Among them was the temple of Sana'a, which was built in honor of Venus, and the one at Mecca, consecrated to Saturn. Stone worship prevailed at an early period among the Arabs, as among many other nations. Stones shaped like the famed Egyptian obelisks and 10 feet high. You can go with me to South Jordan and see it in the city of Petra to this very day. The ancient Nabataean Arabs worshiped these stone carved pillars. I want to ask you, if you've been to the Hajj, why do you kiss that stone in the Kaaba building? 1,000 angels, pardon me, have been appointed to guard the structure. Apparently, they were careless in their duties, because Abraham and his son Ishmael are said to have rebuilt it the first time, and others did the same later after another flood. Some idols of the ancient Arabs are mentioned by name in the Quran. Alat, the chief idol of Taif, is supposed to mean the goddess. Al-Uzza probably symbolized the planet Venus, although it was worshipped as the form of a bamboo tree. Manat was a large sacrificial stone. Suwa was a female deity. Yaqus was in the form of a lion. Ya'uq in the shape of a horse. And Nasr had the shape of an eagle. In front of the Kaaba itself was the great image of Hubal, the garden deity of Mecca. The secrets of Enoch and the testament of Abraham. The subject at hand is the famous Mi'raj of Muhammad. It is recognized as the night in which he went to heaven by way of Jerusalem, riding an animal as long as I could see, whose face was the face of a woman, with cosmetics on it. Aisha, surprisingly enough, declared emphatically, the body of the Prophet of Allah did not disappear, but Allah took away his spirit by night. Here is the passage in Surah Bani Israel, which also has another name, Al-Isra. Here it is. Subhanalladhi asra bi'abdihi laylan min al-masjid al-haram ila al-masjid al-aqsa. Glorified be he who carried his servant by night from the inviolable place to worship to the far distant place of worship. The elaborate story of this vision is expounded in Mishkat al-Masabih, page 518 to 520. Muhammad told how the angel Gabriel took him on the winged animal al-Buraq and showed him all the 7 levels of heaven in one night. The next morning, Muhammad announced that he had seen Adam, Abraham, Moses, Jesus, and others. His followers said, what a wonderful thing. But the fact is, it is not so wonderful when you know the truth. You see, the fact is, we have